night at 9 o'clock, we bring on a special guest, we interview that special guest, and then we do comedy scenes inspired by whatever we find out in the interview. Please welcome to the stage, she is a vet student, which I thought would be a lot of fun for the show. Please welcome to the stage, Teresa Shoemaker. Here she is! See, before the show, I was like, Schumacher. And I go, I'm not going to say it wrong because then I'll be on stage. And she goes, no, it's not Shoemaker. And I was like, oh, you fucked yourself. Because now I'm going to screw it up. So,
did I?
No, I said it wrong. I did. Sorry. Schumacher. How are you?
Good.
Good.
Yeah.
So tell everybody what you do.
I am a vet student at UC Davis.
Woo!
Yeah, so third year. I'm about to start my fourth year clinical. So a lot of animals, large and small. And I'm also a comedian here at Comedy Spot. I do sketch comedy.
Yeah.
Very little spare time.
Yeah. Yeah. But you're already in the mix. Like, it's just not like books and things like that. You're doing work on animals.
Doing surgery.
What kind of surgeries do you do?
I've neutered a lot of dogs.
Cool. I'm gonna ask you a question. This is not to be stupid or anything. I just don't know.
Yeah.
Like, what's the procedure for neutering a dog?
It's actually really fun. You really just, like, you cut into the abdomen and, like, pull them out.
Yeah.
And then you just kind of, like, pull, and you feel like they keep
breathing. It breaks?
And then you, like, you just clamp it off.
Ooh.
It's really satisfying. Yeah.
Do you think about ex-boyfriends when you're doing it? Yeah.
What do you do with the balls?
I have a jar. I don't know, they go in the trash.
Well, you've never had like a person, like a owner of a pet, be like, I need to keep those. Like, out of bronze.
Noodles?
Yeah.
Oh, they're fake balls.
They're like fake boobs for dogs. Yeah, they like put them in the balls.
It's like, so the dog doesn't experience like withdrawals from
yeah.
balls. So they give them little fake balls. Is there a donor service for that?
No.
Some people give blood.
Like truck nuts for dogs?
Yeah!
They just hang there?
They're nut nuts. They're not in truck nuts, they're nut nuts.
No!
Like they're fake nut nuts. Right? Am I missing something? Like, are they prosthetic, like,
yeah!
Holy cow!
Are they, like, saline or salt water? I mean, does one feel more natural than the other?
I just want to see Tiffany going around and be like, nah, those seem fake.
Way too pretty.
Do you have, I am a dog owner, and I'm very into my dog.
Yeah.
I assume there's other people like me out there. Do you ever have anybody, like, do you ever, like, a weird customer come in, like...
All the time.
Oh, what do you...
It's funny, because, you know, I originally went to school to study psychology, I wanted to be a therapist.
Right.
And then I realized that people kind of drive me crazy.
Right.
So I chose to be Batman. But I don't know if you ever noticed, crazy people always have pets. Like, crazy people. So
it's true.
Get away from it.
Yeah. Yeah, so you ended up getting back into the thing you were trying to avoid.
Yeah, now I'm like dealing with crazy people and their animals.
You told us that a bull got loose?
Yeah.
At Davis?
It was my first year, so it was like, I was brand new to the school, and I was at the large animal clinic, and this rodeo bull escaped, got out of its pen, ran all the way to main campus. It was like a total emergency, and like these two cowboys just got him in the truck and were like,
Wait. Do you just have cowboys? Like just on hand in Davis?
Cowboys, yeah.
Like you have a police department and a fucking cowboy department?
They were
students.
Yeah.
So they're like, I got this shit. So then they went, they lassoed.
They did. They caught it.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
What was the, do you remember what the bowl was in for?
I don't know. It's probably
nudicle.
Nudicle?
Do you find that people would like their pets?
Oh, yeah. And they kind of morph into the pets. And, like, it's weird. Like, you get a pet and then you just start looking more and more like them.
So you start looking more and more like your pet after a while.
Yeah.
My dog has a beard, so it's... I do look like my dog. It's true. I sniff butts, too. Yeah. Let's talk about your love life really quick.
Let's not.
So, you're engaged right now.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, good. Congratulations. Good. So, but you were saying that he spends a lot of time on the couch, but not because he's in trouble.
No. We have a lot of animals, and they're very stubborn. They like to sleep in my bed.
So they sleep in the bed.
Yeah. So, he came to visit. He lives in Reno. He came to visit this weekend. Friday night, and the animals all just piled in my bed, and I didn't even know he was there, and I was down on the couch.
What animals do you have? Like, what's the count?
Well, I have two cats, two dogs, a horse, a beta fish, and...
You're forgetting pets! There are so many you're forgetting pets!
Please tell me the horse was in the bed.
Yeah.
What is that, like a first floor apartment in
D.C.? Yeah. You started off like you have an ark. You're like, I have two cats, two dogs, a horse. I was like, all right, it's not an ark.
What's weird too is like the neighborhood animals come from my doggy door too. Like, I just get animals like falling.
You're like Dr. Doolittle.
Yeah. Just the other day, I had some random cat just like walking my doggy door, and I was just sitting on my couch. And
it was like a bro cat. It's like, hey, what's up? Hey, what's up? You look hot. Hey. You're in a two-person improv show called Ritz and Triscuit.
Yes.
The other person in your group is Heather Damon.
Yes.
Can you share with us some stories about Heather that she wouldn't share with us?
Heather is always in my room. It's a little creepy, like I'll come home and she just like dances in my room when I'm not at home.
So you'll come home and she's like...
She'll be like... in my ear, like zoning out, and I'm like, you have a room. She's like, I like yours.
Do you ever wake up at night and she's over like the top of you? Why do I only dance like this? I just realized it. This is not a dance move.
That's a sex move.
Not a good one, because I'm pressing away. Sorry. I had to call it out. Anything else that you'd like to share with these people in front of Heather?
Her cat has herpes.
Are you sure that was the first time the bill cat has been here? Are you sure?
That's so funny!
Yeah.
How do you know cats got herpes?
Actually, like, all cats have herpes.
What?
Herpy eye.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever come across? Like, having...
Besides herpy eye.
Besides herpy eye.
I witnessed CPR on a lizard once. It's crazy because I was in the exotic medicine area, and all of a sudden all these people come rushing in, and they're like, quick, get him off the table, quick, we need epi. Stop. I can't see anything, I'm trying to get over, and
yeah.
I see this woman, like...
Do they bring a crash cart over, and they're like...
I have, like, a DEA
And you do the animals now. Do you like psychoanalyze people depending on what the animals they own?
Jessica the bartender would like to know if you psychoanalyze people based on their pets.
Totally, yeah. You can tell a lot by an animal's pet, like the way they act.
Who's somebody that owns a lizard?
I think this is like a research lizard. It's like super valuable.
Yeah. That's why they're so like, this lizard can't die.
By the way, like, what type of person usually owns a lizard? Let's play a game. I'm going to give a pet. You give a characteristic of somebody that would have that pet. Just one characteristic. All right? Dog.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Yes.
Cat. First thing.
Lonely. Yeah.
that, and I used to rattle and stuff.
Yeah. It used to be a lot louder.
I think you were just like six years old. But you're a surgeon. Like surgically removed.
So let's disrespect her by making her play. So,
shut up, Jeremy!
Don't ruin this! So, I mean, if I know anything about...
What are these things? Do the piece of bread. I love the piece of bread.
No, the frog is toast. You need to go back there. Funny bone.
So we're going to give you 30 seconds to pull out as many of those as possible. How about 20 seconds? This game gets shitty fast.
She's really good at it.
Yeah, what if I do it like 4 seconds?
Can we play just 20 seconds of music? Okay, when you hear the music, you have to start. Somebody count how many beeps she gets. You're in touch of beeps.
Faster!
Yeah! No, that was good. I didn't anticipate everyone yelling. And then when they did, I was like, I want to do this more. All right, Tiffany, will you hand that off stage?
No. I don't remember him having the toilet in his tummy.
No, it's new. This is like the new generation.
It's like the 2013.
So they have like texting thumb.
That's why. You could have done the old school one. Yeah. That was good. Yeah.
They set you up right from the beginning to fail.
I blame Chris.
I blame Chris. Everybody give Teresa a big round of applause.
Hey, Jim. I'm sorry I have to do this to you, man. But Teresa's bedroom's at capacity, man. Sorry. I'm sorry, man.
I'm super tired.
You're gonna have to sleep on our couch with the fiance.
Oh, gross!
Yeah, dude, we got like two cats, two dogs, a horse, a
cat. Well, that's your problem. You got a whole goddamn horse.
I'm sorry.
That could be like 17 cats.
No, I understand, but the horse got there first. I mean. When you came through the doggy door, you understood the rules.
Yeah, suck it, bitch!
I don't like it any more than you do, because that horse is kind of a
dick.
Yeah.
A dick? Come on, dude, you know me. We're cool, right? Remember I came to your offspring's cat mitzvah?
If I was to let you in, she would freaking nutterize me, dude. I want more kids.
Yeah.
You know, if I let you in and she found out, she gets off on that stuff, man. She's like,
can you keep it down out here? Some of us birds gotta get up early in the morning.
Worms, early bird catches.
Oh, come on, that toucan sucks. Maybe puns. I don't think that should count as capacity, because the bird's not even like on the ground.
No, it's not on the perch. It's on the perch. The chandelier.
Yeah.
Just give it down. Come on, man.
It seems like all the animals that sleep in there are animals, right? So you're in your third year of vet school, so you're going to go ahead and start to do some actual surgeries, okay? So the main thing is you just need to stay calm. All right, you've done all the book work, you've done all that foundational stuff, so we're gonna have you get right in there, okay? I'll be here to help you out, and okay. Like I said, the main thing is just to stay calm, okay?
I'll stay calm, yeah.
And another thing is you gotta be ready for anything.
Okay.
While you're in that surgery.
All right.
So let's go ahead and we'll go ahead and step up, and I'm gonna give you the pilot seat, as they say.
Okay. So we're just doing a normal,
neuterectomy here of a cat, right? Right? Okay.
Glad all your book work is paid off.
Let's start. Go ahead. Go! Oh! Oh! You're doing fine. Ah! Oh!
What? What?
Hello!
What?
No, nothing, man. You're good, man.
You're freaking me out a little bit here.
I'm ready for anything, right?
Yeah.
Oh! Oh!
This is a sterile environment! We have to, like, leave and scrub back in!
No, I didn't throw up on it!
But we're adjacent to the throw up!
Hey, don't worry about what's going on over here!
Okay.
Alright?
I'm just gonna go in now, and I'm gonna pull out the tiny little balls on this cat.
Oh! I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna cry.
What? Haven't you done like 18, like, don't you do these every day? I've done like 8,000 of these.
Right, and I cry every single time.
Sew up the incision.
Oh gosh. Oh, the skin just comes up, like it's brought it together, and then you mash it together and you just, oh.
Are you sure you chose the right
position? This is actually dating with this skin. I'm a freak.
So I guess I could say I'm thankful for family, right? Okay, I guess I should just get into this, right? Let's carve this turkey up.
Oh, that was right through the chest, man! Oh! Not thankful for that, brother! Jeez! Oh, jeez, you just took the knife, you didn't even think about it for a second!
I'm carving the turkey.
You're freaking me out, is what you're doing.
This is dinner.
I know what it is!
So happy Halloween! You want to carve it scary or happy?
I don't know!
Somehow I thought being a cowboy would be a little bit more exciting here at UC Davis. But there's like nothing going on ever.
Why'd we decide to do this anyway?
I put some horseshoes the other day on some kid's back. Just because I could.
Some freshman was walking to class. I roped him. Hands to his feet.
Yes.
That was fucked up.
I didn't let him go. Same as being like real cowboys.
Real cowboys.
We should get into some shit.
We should, like some real shit.
Guys, there's a very special research cat on the loose. We need someone to catch it.
Like a saber-toothed cat?
It's a special albino Maine Coon. It's worth thousands of dollars.
How big is it?
Oh, how big is it? Oh,
my God, it's bigger than I thought. Good call, little kid.
That was a full-sized man.
Have you seen that kid compared to that cat?
I got this. You don't have to worry about it.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm gonna... best. We're gonna settle this playing Risk.
So I understand you guys are having some marital problems.
We are, yes. Yes.
Having a hard time connecting with each other.
Absolutely. Yes.
So there's the mat. I just spin this little guy right here. And then looks like left foot green for you, sir. Oh, and take your pants off.
So I know you guys have come on hard times and that you're starving.
Right.
So what we're gonna do is all these little marbles are gonna come out, and if your hippo gets the most marbles.
I'm so very hungry.
Okay.
So your house is infested with mice, you say? I'm just gonna build this thing, and when it's built, you just hit the thing and bing, bing, boom.
Such an elaborate trap. Surely it'll work.
Don't fuck with me anymore. All right? I saw the rope. This is the library.
I need some me time.
Okay.
came up and he was and he was like, I'm a cat. And I was like, no, you're not. He's like, yes, I am. And I was like, oh, okay. And then,
so basically just meowed at you, said that he was a cat, and you just took that?
Yeah, and then we slept together.
Where? What?
Because I've never had sex with a cat before.
That's not a bucket list item that you should.
Look that into that, all right? Everyone makes mistakes. All right, everyone makes mistakes. But it's not, it's...
Let me talk.
Yes, please, let's talk to Brocat.
Meow.
Meow.
No, there's no talk to this bitch.
I want to patch things up, okay? But I just thought that maybe I needed to bring Brocat over here so you'd understand.
Understand that you have herpes?
You don't have herpes?
Yeah, I have herpes.
That's probably Brocat.
Oh, come here! You got your new balls?
I did!
You finally decided on a pair!
I did, yeah!
Let me feel those!
Yeah, go ahead!
Yeah! Are they real? I mean, do they feel real?
They feel, I mean, I shouldn't even have told you that they were fake. Because you would never tell.
Does it even have any other special features? Like you were talking about, like, airbags, like in case you fell.
Exactly, yeah. So, I am an avid jogger.
Right.
And I like to run some treacherous terrain.
I know.
And you never know when you're gonna trip over a stick,
right,
or a dead cat or something. And yeah, they just kind of feel you go down and they expand out and then I bounce back. Remember that toy in the 80s? But be careful, I mean, like, just a little bit of trauma and these things will go.
So if I like, kicked you in the ball?
Yeah.
Alright,
yeah, they did.
One day, we're gonna get out of this sack.
Break the tree.
We're gonna take over.
Yeah.
Like 40 years, I think we need to get the band back together.
Oh.
Do you still have your xylophone?
Yeah, and my sax.
Awesome. I'm gonna get my keytar.
Moistening my reed.
Yeah, baby.
No, I wasn't being sexy. I literally am moistening my reed.
I think that should be the name of our band this time.
Moistening?
The Moist Reed. The Moist Reed.
I don't know if you know this, but the kids today think the word moist is disgusting.
What?
No. It's not like when we were young. Moist was something sweet.
Moist! Like my mother's bosom as a child.
Right.
Look, you've only been here at Betty Crocker for a few weeks as a marketing agent, but the way that you're using the word moist, it's not working out. You're offending a lot of people.
It's not my fault people don't understand metaphors.
Here's Exhibit A, moist. Like my hot taint?
Would you like to feel it? It's pretty moist.
This is one Betty cake.
It is fun.
Yeah, we can't put this on shelves. Okay? We're marketing to kids here.
Mom, I'm having taint cake for my birthday.
Pardon me for just a second, I'm just trying to get this guy to tell me asking what fucking tickets he wants for the concert. You know what? Just hold on a second. What tickets do you want?
I just want two for Fats Domino.
All right. Yeah, I can do that. And there you go.
Thanks. Thank you, sir. Thanks for that.
Yeah, sir, just tell me what you want.
I don't know any other way to describe it.
I keep putting you back in line, but you're fucking confusing me. Just say the words. What do you want to see?
If you don't speak the language of music, then you need a new job, brother. I'm gonna tell you one last goddamn time exactly what tickets to what show I wanna see, okay?
I'm listening.
The final, not a second time or a third time, one last time. This is the last time I'm ever gonna say it. I've already done it 12 other times.
No.
Look, I'm sweating.
Oh, flock of seagulls! No? Fuck! Do it again.
I think it's Billy Squire stroke me.
This end of Charlotte's Web is not any better.